Hello my friends of Hadley Labs, welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial we are going to insert observation points using the hub package but in Modflow 6 and Model Muse. Okay, so what is the issue with that is that the hub package has changed has changed in many ways and some essential ways that we have been used in Modflow 2005 or previous version of Modflow. Okay, so let's see. I'm going to open Modflow 6 model. Okay, you are going to receive the zipped version of this folder. And here I have a model that actually will be called. Okay, will be a copy of that. So this will be V1. Okay. And in this model, we have a complete model for the it's a hill slope groundwater model. And here we have, let's see, our package. We have drains, evapotranspiration, general head, that is the sea, and recharge. Okay, great. And drains as well. So here I can show you the active edge. Okay. And now what I'm going to activate is the observation point package. That is here in observation, and this is the ops. Okay, so it has to be the output format will be text and the number of units thing. Okay. That's it. With that, it's activated. Okay, so what do I have? I have a table where in this table I have the site number, the latitude, the longitude, the datum, and as well the surface elevation, and as well some code. Okay. So I'm going to insert this into the model. If you see, this is in geographical and is in NAT83. My model is in WES8410 North. Okay, so I have to do some tricks with QAS. So here I'm going to open the limit text. Hit this one, great. So this will be X will be longitude. And Y will be latitude, and this is NAT83. Okay, great. And well, let's see. It will convert to well, yes, type okay. Okay, great. So this is our dataset. Okay, but however, in our dataset, we have some wells that do not have water table elevation because actually this comes from a data. From the database, the NWS, National Water Information System. Okay, and there are some wells that are identified as well, but has no water table elevation available. So what we do is that we are going to create a filter. Okay, so where we are going to use the water table elevation higher than zero. Where we have 32. Okay, so these are the values that are higher than zero. Okay, so that actually has some value of water table elevation. Ah, okay, no, there are more values, but there are also values that are less than zero, and here we assume that our database is the lowest value could be zero because otherwise it won't be, I mean, because it's the sea elevation. Okay, so here let me show you, because I have more shape files in order to contextualize where the, so we have, this is the area of interest. Okay, this is the active area. And here we have some streams. So actually, if you see, some points are, since this is a direct download from the database, so we have points that are outside the model. Okay, so but don't worry, because actually model news won't import them. Okay, so let's save as, so this, let's save this as a chip file, and let's say under chip file let's overwrite this one. Okay, and here select EPSG 32610. Great. What else you can do is so far nothing. Okay, overwrite. Okay, great. So here you have your observation points that are close to the area of interest. Okay, and now what we are going to do is that we are going to insert this. Okay, please check which is, since this is in Mulkiteo in Seattle, please check how differs when you project this in NAT 83 and how it is when you change it to WGS 84. Okay, the difference is huge. Okay, however, well, I have selected this. I could select the NAT 83 in UTM as well. Well, I have no certain criteria of what is the main. Okay, but it has to be UTM. It has to be meters. Okay. Great. So this is the model. Okay, and then we have file, import chip file, and here we have the chip file, and this is the chip file that we have created with the observation points that have water table elevation higher than zero, set value of intersected cells, one formula, and this will be related to the attribute to the screen elevation. The screen elevation is actually the point where the observation point, the middle elevation of the screen depth, okay, of the piezometer. Okay, so we have this one, and then here on features, let's call it to observation utility. Okay, and what is new in ModFlow 6 is that you can actually relate observation not only to observation points, but you can use boundary as observations. I have to search on that. I mean, it's really useful because sometimes you calibrate with base flow. Okay, so here we use the side code head observation. That's it. And those are the observation points, and then if you see, these ones won't be interpreted on the model. Okay, so we can save our model, and then we can run our model. Okay, let's check the water balance. And as I have seen in ModFlow 6, if you don't have, there is an issue. If your water balance is, I mean, it could convert, I mean, you could have a lower discrepancy. However, if you cannot, if you are not, if the water balance, I mean, for example, if you have positive values in, or like inflow from drains, actually the observation points won't give you nothing. I mean, it will give you values of heads, of simulated heads of zero. Okay, and here the recharge is 0.71 cubic meters per second, while the drainage is really low, is 0.06 or maybe close to 7. The most all goes to the sea as general head boundaries, and the evapotranspiration is really is the second discharge, that is 0.12. Okay, great. And then we can close this. And let's see. Okay, so we have inserted, and what is the main difference in between Modflow 6 and Modflow 2005 is that observation points are not long, I mean, that are strictly related to the cell, and then you define a point where you are going to define your observations. However, you cannot insert the observated value, you cannot insert the observated value, and Modflow won't compute the residual. Okay, so it was possible here, for example, let's see, in Modflow 2005 we can do something, we can work with that, but in Modflow 6 is disabled. Okay, and how we are going to do that? We can do that with FlowPy or with any, I mean, it's really easy to do with just Python. Okay, so I will open an Anaconda prompt. Okay. See the documents, see the how to insert Jupyter Lab. Ah, okay. I don't know if that happened to you, but if you cannot open Jupyter Lab in this way, you can try this Jupyter Lab. Okay. I have disabled Microsoft Edge for my computer, so I just have to copy paste this under I use the dark mode, but you can use it in light. Okay, great. So with that, our model will be V2.1. Kernel clear all outputs. First, we import the required package. Then define model name and model path. Open the observation file. Outheads. Why? Because there are two. Okay. If you go to the model, okay, here is where the observation points are located, and this is the output where the observation heads are located. Okay, so this is the observation points, all the observation points, and this is layer row column, while these ones are just the heads. Okay, this is just the heads. Okay. And then here we create a data frame for the observation points, and let's check that here we have the simulated will be taken from this. However, we create a space for the observer and as well for latitude and longitude. Okay. Here I have to run this. Run this. Okay, kernel, restart clear all outputs. Run this. Okay. So here we have the observation point with a suffix of head observation that comes from this file. With some code you can get rid of this. Okay, I haven't considered that so crucial. Okay, and then we open the observation values. Okay, these are the observation values. Okay, but these are the observed data, the no data, everything. Okay, and open the observe data file. And here, what we are going to do is We are going to we are going to look for the observe elevation and coordinates. Why? Because for this data frame, what is missing is the observed elevation and the coordinate, but just for the ones that are simulated, because as you well, not only for the ones that are simulated, but the ones that are inside the model. Okay, so and then what we do here is two iterations of we do two iterations over the pandas data frame, and with that we got the observed elevation and the latitude and longitude. Okay. And then we compute the residual. Compute the residual and store and save CSV file. Okay, why we save the CSV file? Because actually, what we are going to do is a graphic, is a graph with Python, but as well we are going to have the CSV file where we have the original, the not the original, the common format of simulated of hair and residual. Okay, here is where we are going to have simulated, observed, and residual. Okay, while the residual is simulated minus observed. Okay, and then we can create some fancy, and these are the files. Okay, where we have, let's see that here, -5 +5. Yeah. Okay, and this is a file that where you can have the what you had as well before in Model Muse, the simulated and the observed, and well, this is just will be a part of the calibration, because my next step will be to understand what is going on with this and why we have simulated values. The problem is that I have lot of water here, so what does it mean that here my simulated value is higher than the observed value? So let's see where those are. Okay, and here in QAS I will open, I mean the script creates this hop out, so I'm going to open this as a delimited text, and this is lot and lat, and this is still in NAT83. Okay, I will do some, I will give some transparency to the original one. Okay, and here I will do properties, graduated, classify according to the residual, spectral, classify. Okay, from the orange to the green, those will be the where I have. Very interesting. Because as you have seen here in the graphic, yeah, as you have seen here in the graphic, I have lots of values where the simulated head is higher than the observed head. I mean higher by 20, okay, and this is like in a bunch of files. However, when I plot that here, it could be that all of these values are located in just one point, and that happened to me a lot. So if I select this, and then if I open the attribute table, interesting, because I only have here 3 points. I don't have many points here. Let me check this code. Okay, let me review this. Those are the negative simulated observe this value 104, let's see, 108.80 simulated 108. Observe. Ah, okay. Yes, so sorry, here is the opposite. This is the X, this is the observe, and this is the simulate. Okay, great. So yes, we have 100, then we have this 110 and 80, because this is 110 and 80. Okay, great. So here we have some values where the store value is high, where the observe, the simulated value is higher than the observed. So here we have more water. And where is this? Those are in this, those are here, and here. And then we have values that where I need more water, and those are here, and here. And as well, in those points, okay, I need more water in those points because those points became dry on the simulation. Okay, so I need more water in here. However, I have a lot of water here. Well, this is just another part of the model calibration, okay? However, now you, with this applied case, you know how to put your, how to set your observed values in model Muse in and ModFlow 6, okay? Your observation points. Thank you for following this, and you will have the description of this video. You will have the the code, the files, and the purpose is that you can create this in order to do your own project. Okay, great. Have a great day. Bye bye. Bye.